For this tutorial, we will be building an indoor project, and I will show you how to both make a tour and a game. Start by making a free account with us if you haven't done so already, and log in. You'll be taken to a dashboard from which you can create projects. Select New Project. Give your project a name. Choose your primary language, you can add others later. And select Indoor Project. Indoor projects consist of floors and stations. You need to have at least one floor, and on it you can put a floor plan graphic and stations that will appear on top of it. If you don't have a floor plan and want to continue with just stations, you can skip the floor plan and then the stations are presented as a list in the app. Let's start by clicking on Edit here to open the project information and settings. Here we can give the project a name that will only be visible in the CMS. Let's start with the content. Here you find the information which your users will see when they first access your project in the app. So, give your project an image or logo. Here we can add more languages. Just remember to provide translations at all stations. You can modify your title, add a description of the project, and give your location a name. You can also upload an audio or video file if you want an introduction before the user downloads the project. To reduce download time for your users, keep any video files uploaded here under 30 seconds. With a premium license, you can choose an extended layout template for more customization, like adding additional slides and changing the color of the background, text, and title. Under the Location tab, we have the Location service. For this tutorial, we are using iBeacons, but you can also use the ultra-wideband integration we offer for precise location detection. The UWB installation consists of anchors mounted on walls and tags. This is useful when you need more accurate location detection, but it is also a pricier alternative that needs infrastructure to work. For more information on ultra-wideband, please refer to our FAQ section. Another option is to use no location service. This means that the stations are activated only by pressing on them on the screen. In our project, the beacons are what activate our stations and floors and unlock their content. The beacons are small battery-driven devices that can easily be placed around the venue, near the subject the user would be standing in front of when the app automatically activates the content when the user is within a certain range of the beacon. The beacons are registered in the CMS and associated with the stations or floor plans that they should activate. Here you can upload and manage coupons, which are a useful premium feature and a great way to integrate local business sponsorship. Coupons are rewards, such as local discount vouchers or collectible digital items, and are only rewarded to users if the project is set up as a game. For more information on coupons or rewards, please see the FAQ section on our website. Under Advanced, you can decide if you want your project to be visible in the app, or if you want to restrict access so that your users need an invitation code to join. Here you also find some premium settings, like if you want to enable time-based games. This only applies if your project is set up as a game, and if you want to request users' email when they join the project. And here in project category, we select either tour or treasure hunt, depending on our project type. Click on Game Over message to give your users a directions to start message for when they begin the project, and a Game Over message if we're making a game. We can also come back to this part when we're done with adding our floors and stations if we want to update. Now click Save and Close so we can add our first floor. On the left panel here, click on Add Floor. This is where you add the content that your users will see and hear on this floor. Start by giving the floor a name here in the CMS. the content section, we can upload background ambient audio, like a song that we want to have play on a loop in the background while this floor is activated, and if we want it to start playing automatically. Here, we can add more languages. Here, we need to provide a name for the floor that will be visible for your users in the app. And if you want, you can add floor audio, which activates when the user enters the floor, which then stops when a station is activated. This will play over any ambient background audio uploaded above. Now we click on Floor Map to upload our floor map graphics where our station graphics will be placed upon. Remember, if you just have stations and no floor plan, you can skip the floor map graphics and then the stations are presented in a list in the app. So click on Select Map to upload your floor map. Here we enter the size of the floor in meters, width and height. And then we drag the square to define the margins of our floor. The highlighted area should match the measurements above. Now click on Save and Close so we can continue with the stations. On the right panel here, next to Station, we're going to click on Add Station, and then click again on our floor map where we want to add this station. When the station image appears, click on it so you can drag it to the right position and size it correctly. Here we can name the station in the CMS. And upload our own custom active and inactive images that represent the station on the floor map. We need to give our station a title that will be visible to users. Here we upload the audio guide for the station. It will start playing automatically when the station is activated. And on to the information layout. Here you add the description text for this station. And you can also choose to have the pop-up window display automatically when the station is activated. If you have a premium license, you can choose templates to add more content to the station to further customize the look. If you want to activate the game element, click on Treasure and start by attributing a score for finding this treasure location. You can decide if you want to lock the station so that the treasure cannot be unlocked unless the station has been activated. And you can add an image that will become visible when the treasure is found. Now select Add a Challenge and choose your challenge type. We have a few types of question and photo challenges, but let's just pick a memory game challenge for now. Make sure to select a score for completing the challenge successfully. Please check out our challenges tutorial video in the FAQ section with more information about challenges. Now click on Save and close this station. So we will start by adding our beacons to our beacon library. So let's start by clicking on the name of the station we want to add a beacon to and then add beacon to station. The iBeacons or beacons are Bluetooth Low Energy Devices, or for short, BLE. Apple introduced the iBeacon standard for smartphone apps to detect their proximity and perform an action. There are many iBeacons providers out there, but we have worked with a company called Contact.io who provide beacons that are both durable and easy to administer. Contact.io provide an app that can be used to read the iBeacon values from the beacon in order to enter them into our CMS, as I will show you. Beacons are identified by three properties. They are major number, minor number, and UUID. The combination of the three numbers is unique for each device. The numbers are normally preset on the beacon, and you would simply enter them in the CMS when you register the beacons with our system. The beacon's power level can be configured from 0 to 7 in the app. Most accuracy is gained with power level 7, but often power level 3 to 4 is sufficient. Start by clicking on Add Beacon to give your beacon a title. Here you see that the UUID autofills with a number from contact.io. But if you use another provider, you will have another number, so just copy it and paste it here. Insert the major and minor numbers as you see them in your app. Good. Now let's click on Save and add this beacon to a station. Drag it like this and place it on the station where you want it to activate content. Here, the X and Y axis fields autofill in regards to where you drag the beacon. But you can also fill in these numbers manually. And below you set the radius. The proximity measurement is best within 1 to 2 meters distance from the beacon, and accuracy will decrease the further away you go. iBeacon's proximity is normally divided into immediate, within a meter, near, within 6 meters, and far, within 30 meters. Please keep this in mind when selecting a distance for your beacons. And here you can choose if you want this beacon to activate the floor or only this station. If you choose floor activation, it will also appear on the side panel under floor activation beacons. Now we're ready to test our project. Select the publish button up here. First, you should try your project on a phone by publishing it for testing. This means that it is only available to download in the app using a test code. So select Test on Device. And now download the Locatify Smart Guide app to your mobile device from the App Store or Play Store if you haven't already. And select Create Test Version. From within the Locatify Smart Guide app, you can redeem your test project with either the QR code or the invitation code displayed here. Please note, we only allow a test code to be redeemed on one device. If you want to redeem it on another device, you'll need to publish it again for testing. When you're done with testing and ready to publish, select Publish to App. And choose which plan is best for what you need. And that's how you make an indoor project with a Locatify Creator CMS.